Okay, folks, well, welcome back to video number 5.4 in our Long Dark Stalker playthrough series. Why the 0.4? Well, we have had some fun with this. This is my fourth attempt at filming this video. On every other go, my computer has randomly turned itself off for no reason. Well, there is a reason, and I'll get techie about it in a minute, but to cut a long story short, picking up from the end of video number 4, I started to record, I managed to do 25 minutes, computer crashed, I lost the video. I tried to do it again twice, and it crashed again twice. So we're now on the fourth attempt, but obviously we have lost a bit of video. From after the end of video number 4, I did a bit of housekeeping, tidied up my inventory, put stuff away, and then I slept through the night, and that's the last point the game saved. So that's the point I reverted back to when the computer crashed. So that is where we now are. So all said and done, we've lost about 5 minutes of gameplay from the end of video number 4 to where we are now. But all I have done in that 5 minutes of lost footage is just tidy up my inventory, put a few things away, and that's about it really. That's all we've done, that's all we've lost. And we've slept through the night, and it is now 2 hours of darkness remaining. Weather outside is not sounding great, but what we are going to do is we're going to set up for the radio tower. We're going to do it now, and I'm going to, basically, this is now the fourth time I've tried to do this, so hopefully it will now work. I made some technical adjustments, and we'll talk about those in a sec. So let's head downstairs. It is still dark, but we're going to have a go at doing this in the dark. And fingers crossed, all will be well. Okay, so first things first, I'm going to do my little trick that I used to do a long time ago when I first played The Long Dark, is I'm going to drink coffee and take a brand with me to help keep me warm whilst I'm outside in that really cold weather as we're travelling up to the radio tower, which is where we're heading to. So let's light a fire and drink some of this hot coffee, and hopefully that will help get us to the radio tower in one piece. So yeah, this has been an interesting video number 5, I tell you that. Basically what happened is, for the technical folks out there, my computer was kind of random, but my computer was suffering a CPU over temperature failure. So the CPU was getting too hot, so it shut itself off. But it was really weird because it happened in exactly the same place every single time. Every single time I tried to play through the game, I got to the radio tower, opened the door, and then it crashed. So I think it was the additional load. Oh, darn it. I was too busy talking and I ended up losing the fire. I think it was the additional load on the CPU of doing the game save that caused it to overheat and crash, ultimately. So that's the point where it was failing every time. But it didn't matter how long I took to get there, how long I was playing before I got there, whether I rushed there, whether I went there slowly, it crashed in exactly the same place every time. But it was a CPU overheat failure that caused it to happen. Really, really weird. But what I've done is I have put a bigger heatsink on my CPU. I had a performance heatsink upstairs in the loft, and I have fitted said performance heatsink, and it seems to be working. I've been playing Fallout 4 just off camera by myself today, and it seems to have worked. So fingers crossed, we're now going to be able to get through the Long Dark playthrough, this video, without it crashing. I have had a little monitor running that's been displaying on the screen, keeping an eye on the CPU temperature, and it's not been getting anywhere near the point where it was crashing. So I am hopeful that we'll get through this. It's not running now for some reason, but hopefully we'll get through this. But anyway, so basically what I've done, I've lit a fire. I am wasting a little bit of that fire. I should only put one bit of wood on it, really, but never mind. I've drank some coffee, and I now have a flaming brand with me. The coffee gives me a bonus to my temperature and my tiredness. So as you can see, my I'm going to get colder more slowly, and I'm going to get tired more slowly because of that boost from the coffee. So that's really useful thing to do. So let's head outside. That's going to help us get across this really cold air outside. Not too bad. It's looking a little bit breezy. Yeah, this is a little bit breezy actually. Well, we're going to give it a go anyway. I'm kind of living on the edge. because I don't want to just have a load of videos where we're just kind of sitting around, to be honest. I'd like to keep things moving and do some stuffs. That's what we want to do. So we'll head off across the orchard. We're heading for the radio tower. Radio tower is up there, as you can see. Well, hopefully you can see, because we are travelling at night. And I know the video gets a bit darker when it gets published, so hopefully you can see the radio tower on top of the hill. I'm going to head across this way towards the road. I could go that way, but you tend to get a lot of wolves out on this plain, and particularly over there. So I'm going to kind of cut the corner a bit, but not too much. I can't see any wolves, but they do tend to hang around over there. So I'm going to kind of do a bit of a cut and head for the road. Temperature's minus 23, so it is a bit cold. But that coffee and the bran that we're carrying is just helping keep us a little bit warmer. So, by the way, if you can hear any crashing and banging, the hamster is out in her ball and she keeps running into things. So, if you can hear crashing and banging in the background, that's what it is. Oh, my bran's been blown out. That's really helpful. Let's get rid of that then. That's not good to me. Any more? I don't think it makes that much of a difference anyway. Okay, I'm heading for that gap in the fence to get onto the road. And I'm doing this with a lot more hope than I've done the last few goes at this. I've done this 3 times now, and I've always made it to the radio tower, and that's where it's gone wrong. So I'm hoping we come out the other side, and we get there. No wolves around, so we're all good. Okay, so what we're going to do, we're going to go up to the radio tower, we're going to loot it, see what's up there. Then we're going to make our way back to the farmstead, and I think then we're probably in the next video, we're going to have to go and do some hunting. Because we are a little bit short of food. So what I'd like to try and do is sort out some food stash. And then I think I might go and explore a few bits of the map that I haven't really explored. I don't know Pleasant Valley as well as I know Mystery Lake. So I might go around and have a look around bits of the map I haven't explored and see how we do. See if we can find some things I've not found before. And I am then tempted at some point to have a go for Timberwolf Mountain, but I want to make sure I'm ready for it before I do it, because every other time I've been to Timberwolf Mountain, I've died. I still have not summited Timberwolf Mountain. So, let's hope we can actually make it. I think we're going to make that our goal for this series, is to get to the summit of Timberwolf Mountain and get back down again without dying. That's the plan. Because we're still waiting on story mode. Oh, I've just noticed there's some saplings there. I might gather those on the way back. We're still waiting for story mode. I don't think it's far away. I need to look on the forums and the various things. I was meaning to do that when I did this video. But because of all these problems I've had, I've kind of got a bit distracted and things like that. So I haven't actually done it. So hopefully I can get on the forums and have a quick look at any updates or progress logs or posts or whatever's on there that I've not seen. Just to see where we are with story mode, really, because I think we're all on tenterhooks for story mode, really. I mean, I've done 4-5 sandbox playthroughs now, and I'm just kind of, it is a little samey for videoing. It's fine if you're just playing it, and you're just playing it through and seeing how you get on, but when you're trying to constantly think of new things to do, it gets a bit samey. So I think this is going to be the last long dark sandbox playthrough that I do. When we die in this one, I think we're going to leave it, call it quits until we get to story mode. I have been thinking a little bit about what to do with this channel, because if you don't know this, I actually have another channel. I have a photography channel which has got a few videos on it, but it's quite a well-viewed channel. There's a lot of subscribers on it. And there's a lot of hits on it. And I really want to do something for it. I really want to make some more photography content for it. So I think I'm going to be doing a lot of my kind of non-gaming content. It's going to be photography related. And it's going to be on that channel. So I am thinking this channel is going to become... I'm going to turn this into pure gaming. I've always said... Oops, I haven't put the phone on silent. Oh, be quiet. I've always said that this... this channel is a bit of everything. But I think I'm actually going to turn this more into a gaming channel. I'm going to try and broaden it out a bit. put a few more games, different games on there. I'm going off in the wrong direction here. There's the radio tower. It's actually gone quite nice. That's 14 degrees. I'm gonna stick with gaming on this one, and I'm gonna try and do a bit more variety on gaming stuff. I've been editing together a Minecraft tutorial video, but it's not working out quite the way I like. It's taking a lot longer than I wanted to do it. It's really clunky and it's really complicated to edit it. Because I'm playing on the PS4 and I have the 15-minute recording limits. It's only 720p, and it's really clunky, the controls and doing all that stuff. So I'm actually thinking of swapping that over, recording that on the PC and doing a whole series of tutorials for Minecraft and playthrough of Minecraft. And I think we're also going to be doing a bit more of the World Rally Championship videos as well. And Kerbal Space Program. I want to get back on Kerbal Space Program, the games that I like to play. So I think this is going to become mainly gaming. And then there'll be the photography channel as a separate channel. And then I might just sort of see where other bits of content slot in, really. And see how we do. But that's what I've been thinking for the last couple of days. Right then, moment of truth. This is the point where it kept crashing. Whenever I went through this door. So let's see what happens. Can we make it inside the signal tower? We're in! Hallelujah! It hasn't crashed! Oh, you have no idea how happy that makes me feel. We're inside! Okay, so it was obviously heatsink related issues. So new heatsinks fixed the problem. And we are up and running. So, I'm going to stop babbling now. We're inside Signal Hill. We've reached the radio tower. We're back in the warm. And we are now going to loot. So we have a storm lantern. And I'm actually going to light it. Because it's going to help us with what we're doing. Lantern fuel, we shall have. Bandage, we shall have. See what's in this container. Hey, an MRE, that's handy. Good, good, good. Let's have a look on the floor. Yep, rifle round. Anything in the lockers? Newsprint, yep, I'm running out of tinder, so that's actually quite useful. A decent cotton toque, which I may or may not be pronouncing properly. And apps. Oh, no, we've got some boots. Okay, they're going to be quite heavy, so I'm going to be encumbered at this point, but we won't worry too much about that. I'm going to sort that out in a bit. Cardboard box I can actually break down for tinder, so I'm going to do that. And now everything goes straight into your inventory, which is much easier than it dropping on the floor. Okay, we'll do that room in a minute. Let's do this room first. That is a candy bar, so we'll have that. Another rifle round in the corner. Anything else lying about? Okay, so it's now all in the drawers. Let's have a look through the drawers. Nothing. Nada. Well, this is going well. Absolutely nothing. He's cleared his desk, quite literally. Let's have a look in the filing cabinet. A granola bar. Nothing. Another toque. And nothing. They definitely have balanced this because you really don't find many things in drawers anymore. Oh, but we have a lot of good stuff in here. Excellent. Okay, what we got under here then? Snow pants. Take it. Okay. Another emergency stim and soda. And in this locker, another rifle cartridge. Plenty of those. Water, always useful. Getting pretty encumbered now, I suspect. Another sport vest. I think it was worth coming up here. We've got some good stuff. Obviously, we've got beds. Oh, we've got a rifle as well. Excellent. Yep, I could definitely use this. Another rifle. That gives us two rifles. Sewing kit. Nothing in the microwave. A rifle cleaning kit. An Expedition Parker. Excellent. Food. Quite a bit of it. Can opener. Tea.
This pack is getting too heavy to carry.
Yeah, I know. Don't worry. We're going to sort that out in a minute. Anything in the drawer? And obviously we have a workbench. And that is a fire striker. Always useful. Can I break the chair down? I can break the chair down. There isn't anything to light a fire in here, though, which is the downside. It's outside. Okay, so how badly over-encumbered are we? Ooh, very. We're 11.5 kilos over our weight. Right, okay. I have to do something with that. Well, let's get into the clothing and see what we actually have here and whether any of it's better than what we're wearing. So, on our outer, we are wearing a decent Mariner's pea coat. The Windbreaker is worse. The Expedition Park. Now the Expedition Park is actually better than the pea coat. In terms of, I think that's condition, isn't it? It's better in terms of pretty much everything, bar the waterproofness and protection it offers. It's nowhere near as good. But in terms of warmth, it's much better. So I'm going to pop that on. My jacket that I've got underneath. Oh, I can actually put them both on. Oh, that's kind of cool. I can put my Mariner's pea coat on underneath my parka. There we go. So we get the best of both worlds. So basically, I'm wearing two coats and then two underlayers. So that's cool. I do like this new clothing system. I'm still getting used to it, but I do like it. So warm work boots. Combat boots are in every way worse apart from waterproofness and protection. I don't know what that actually is, that one there. Oh, it's sprint. So that I can run faster wearing those than I can wearing these. Because presumably these have got steel caps in. They weigh more. Oh no, they weigh less. That's strange. 94. I mean, the condition is a lot lower. I'm trying to work out. I mean, I can't really carry them both back. I'm going to have to drop those ones. What am I? Okay, I'm wearing worn jeans. Snow pants are better in every single way, apart from the fact they're a little bit heavier. And apparently they encumber us more with air. So the higher that is, the more encumbered we get with sprinting. The lower it drops our sprint level down. I see. Well, I'm going to swap them over because they give us better warmth, which is kind of what we need at the moment. I'm not too worried about sprinting. And, oh, my warm work pants are a little bit wet. But that's fine. They're only 2% wet. We'll leave those on. Right. So, head. I'm wearing a decent cotton toque. And I have a decent wool toque, which gives us better in every way apart from it's a little bit heavier. But I'm going to wear it. And it's nice, and it's, you know, Canadian as well. It's all cool. And I think we're going to leave the scarf on because I think the scarf gives us better. That's it. So I'm actually going to drop these two toques because I don't need to be carrying those. Let's ditch the weight. There we go then. So we've got a warmth bonus of plus 13, windproof of plus 6, protection of 23, and it's got our maximum sprint is 71. So we're a little bit encumbered by all this heavy clothing. But to be honest, I'd rather have the warmth than the sprinting at this point. So I'm quite happy with that. The only thing is, presumably, it will make us get more tired more quickly if it's heavier. Okay, so we've sorted our clothes out. So let's have a quick look at what else we've got. Are we still carrying anything that we don't want to take back with us? Yeah, let's drop that. And let's drop that. And let's drop that. I'm tempted to keep those, though. I don't know. I mean, that's thermal underwear, that's snow pants. I mean, trying to decide whether to keep them. Oh, nah, I'm going to drop them. I think we've probably got another pair back at the thing anyway. Right, so okay, so we've dropped all the clothes we're not carrying. We've actually shed 5 kilos of weight, so that's quite good. Anything else we're carrying we don't need to be carrying. I mean, obviously I am carrying a spare rifle, but I really don't want to leave that behind. And same actually goes for the storm lantern, although I am actually using all the fuel up because I never turned it off. Let's turn that off. I don't really want to leave anything behind. I might take the risk, you know. I might take the risk and try and get back with what I'm carrying. Let's turn this into tinder plugs. I think I'm going to take a chance. I think I might need some food. So I can probably eat my way out of some of my weight issues. Obviously, we've still got those burns as well. From video number 4, if you remember, where I accidentally stood in the fire and I burnt myself. I've still got the burns. So my maximum condition at the moment is 75%. And I don't have any way of healing those at the moment. So I am a little bit stuck with that. Okay, I'm just going to eat and drink my way out of a little bit of this weight issue. Which I think we've probably done okay there. Yeah, we're 5 kilos overweight, but I think we're okay. We've pretty much got everything. We've got a little pile of clothes on the floor there that we're not going to take with us. But we've pretty much got everything else, so this has been quite a nice little lightning coach tour version of the of a raiding run up to the radio tower. So I think it's time to head back to the farmstead. This is kind of how I'm doing it. I'm really doing these very high-speed trips out and then high-speed trips back. I'm literally going out, looting, and coming back in. Let's see what the weather's doing. Hopefully it's alright. It's not too bad. Temperature minus 9. That's okay. Let's head out. And I think what we're going to do... Let's just come out to the edge of the cliff and just have a quick nosy. Let's get rid of this as well. We don't need to carry that around. It's a little bit misty. There we go. Oh, you don't get such a great view. That's the orchard there. There's the road. There's the orchard. So the farmstead is just there. You can just about make it out with the silo sticking up there. Quite high up. We wouldn't want to go any further forward and fall off this. That would suck a bit. So it's fairly clear. So let's make our way back. I'm not going to... I did spot those saplings, which I'm going to need for crafting things later, but I'm not going to pick those up on the way back. I don't know if you noticed them as we were coming up the hill on the right-hand side. I did notice them, but I'm not going to harvest them just yet because I'm obviously already overweight, so I don't want to get any more overweight. Now, is there some... I did spot out the corner of my eye some old man's beard somewhere. If it's not too far, there it is. I'm going to just go and grab that. Because it's the first old man's beard I've seen on this map so far in this playthrough. So I haven't been able to make any wound dressings yet. So I'm going to... I really want that for wound dressings. There was some more, wasn't there? Am I being blind? There was some more, wasn't there? Yeah, there it is, over there. Okay, I'm going to collect it all. Because it doesn't weigh very much, so it'll tip us slightly over our weight again, but it's negligible. It hardly weighs anything. So we're going to craft that into some wound dressings, which I think I can actually do from the crafting menu here. I don't need a workbench anymore for that. So let's try it. Yeah. So let's craft it. That was probably a mistake. I shouldn't have done that outside. Okay, that's made us a bit chilly. I'll tell you what then, what I'll do, I'll go back in the radio tower and we'll get our temperature back up before we venture back to what's it. And we'll just do a little bit of that crafting, sort that out. We might even be able to dress our wounds. We might even be able to dress our burn wounds and get that sorted out. I don't know if the old man's beard... I don't think Old Man's Beard was actually one that you could use that with. I'm sure the Rose Hip Tea is, but I can't remember how to make it. I'm sure you made it by cooking it on a fire, but I haven't had the option to, or I certainly didn't when I tried to do it. I honestly can't remember how to make it. I meant to look that up, actually. Jump back inside. In many ways, this isn't actually a bad base because you're relatively well protected in here. It's actually not a bad base because you've got a bed, which I'm actually just going to use to sleep for an hour. Just to get... I think that will give me a little bit of a condition boost, hopefully. And it'll certainly warm us back up again. Yep, there we go. So we're 5 days, 2 hours in to this playthrough. What was I doing? Crafting. Let's craft a... Oh, I can't craft another one. Oh, I've only got 4. Okay, so I've only crafted one that I need. Can I craft a... I can craft a torch. Okay, let's do that then. Let's craft a torch. Excellent. I crafted 2. Okay, well that's cool. So let's use our fire striker to light one of these torches. There we go. Woo, let's not go backwards, let's go forwards. And now we're going to have a go at getting down to the farmstead again. I'm mildly concerned the hamster's gone very quiet. That usually means trouble. No, she's having a wash, that's why. Oh, it's gone a little bit blusterier out here. -4 though, it's actually got warmer. That's well, that went well. That went very well. That was almost worth doing. Okay. Let's holster that then. That's not going to work. It's gone a bit windy. Okay, let's make our way down then. Keeping our eyes open for wolves and bears. Particularly when we go around this corner and head down. You do get bears, so we need to be a little bit careful. Ooh. It's getting a bit blustery. But we're okay. We're fine. Let's just keep going. Another sapling over there. I think I might be making a return visit up here, actually, for saplings and things, because there's some saplings knocking around over here. Plus, I'm sure there's other stuff around here that I haven't actually properly looked for yet, so I really don't know this map very well at all. There's a wolf over there, but that's fine. We're heading this way. And we're going down now, so it'll be a bit faster. Just kind of do a little bit of a cut. Yes, we're aware it's cold. It's actually gone to -6 now, because we're kind of sheltered a little bit where I'm walking. So it's the wind that's making it very cold. Well, I'm a little bit more sheltered where I am at the moment. That will change. We are going to have to go out into the open, however you slice it. We're not doing too bad. We're well out of the wind down here. It's a little bit hazy as we make our way round. Yeah, so as I was saying, what I think I'm going to do, we're going to concentrate on this being a gaming thing mainly, I think. And I'm going to put all the content on the other channels, I think. That's what we're going to do. So that's the plan going forward. Sorry, there's a lot of noise going on round outside. I'm trying to work out what it is. I'm a little bit jumpy because I had a bird fly in here yesterday and it was flying around all over the place. And maybe, you know, it was... it woke me up. Let's put it that way. It was actually while I was trying to fix this computer and it was flying around my head. So I'm a little bit iffy if I hear strange noises at the moment from inside the actual building rather than in the game. Okay, so here we are. We're back down on the road. So yeah, what I think I'm going to do, we're going to make this primarily gaming, and I'm going to try and do content every day, if I can, and mix things up a little bit. Keep it to the games that I like to play, which is The Long Dark, racing games, and things like Kerbal Space Program, construction-type games, Minecraft, and things like that. So, well, that's what we're going to try and do, and I'm going to try and mix things up, but try and keep content relatively... in groups. So if we're doing Minecraft tutorials, we'll stick with tutorials, and then if we're doing a playthrough or let's play, we'll stick with that. Just to try and keep things simple, really. I'm just trying to come up with a better, more consistent way of producing content that I'm happy with and that doesn't take insane amounts of time to make. As some of these videos do. The Long Dark's nice and simple. See, one thing about The Long Dark is obviously you don't have this ability to save the game and jump backwards to past save points. If you die, you die, and that's it, end of game. You can't jump back. Certainly in the sandbox. It would probably be different in the story mode, but certainly in the sandbox, you don't have multiple saves that you can step back to. It's all very continuous. So you play the game and you... I don't skip anything, there's no cutting or anything with The Long Dark. You just see everything that happens. Nothing gets cut out. Whereas with other games, I'm having to do a lot more editing and it's taking forever. Okay, there we go. We have the farmstead in our sights. Looking pretty clear. -10 down here.
God.
Okay, so we are at risk of hypothermia, but we're not too far away from the farmstead. I'm actually aiming for the barn there. Not too far away from the farmstead, so we should be okay. Can't see anything nasty around here. You have to be a bit careful for bears and wolves. The bear does come and wander around here, so you have to be a bit careful. More than one occasion I've opted to go outside and come face to face with the bear walking up the road and run back in again. Although it's a little bit more awkward if you're approaching to come in and you come across the bear, because then you're kind of stuck. You have to kind of dodge around it and run. But that's where the farmstead has its other advantage, because not only have you got this porch, which gives you the chance to kind of look around before you go outside, it's also got multiple other entrances and exits that you can use. There's doors on virtually all sides, so if you need to run very quickly, you can aim for any side of the building and you will be able to get in. But today we haven't got to worry about that, it's all nice and clear. So let's head inside. See, there's a door over there and there's a door at the front. You've got the cellar on this side and the door around the back, so many, many doors. So, back inside. A nice little run, I think. A nice little looting run. And I finally managed to do it without the game crashing, which is an even bigger bonus. Okay, so there we go. We're back in the farmstead. So what we've basically done today, we've been over to the radio tower. We've finally, after four attempts, made our way to the top of the radio tower. And we found quite a lot of decent loot, actually. We got a little bit of food. We didn't get much, but we got a bit. That'll keep us going for a bit. We've got a spare rifle. We've got quite a lot of clothing. We've done a bit of clothing swapping. And a few other odds and ends. And we're back here. So I think at the start of the next video, we'll sort it all out, get our housekeeping done. And then we'll think about something to do next. Another place to go and explore. Maybe a section of the map I haven't been to. But that's going to be next time. So I am going to say thank you very much for watching. And I shall see you again very, very soon for some more Long Dark.